Welcome everyone. The course is addressed to all parties involved in construction. This lecture about the sectional completion in construction projects. Most standard form contracts provide for only one certificate of practical completion, one certificate of making good defects and one defects liability period, or their equivalents. Employers and contractors often run into difficulties where the employer has chosen to incorporate sectional completion into the contract. Where a project is split into sections, any extensions of time must be given in respect of the particular section affected by the delaying event. A common problem occurs where a sectional completion supplement has been properly used, but two or more of the sections are interdependent. For example, a school project may be divided into four sections, but section 3 of may be dependent on section 1 in the sense that the contractor cannot be given possession of section 3 until section 1 has reached practical completion. That may be because the occupants of section 3 have to be moved to section 1. Actually, section 1 is not finished by the completion date. That may be because the contractor has been inefficient, or events have occurred which entitle the contractor to an extension of time. What if the contract provision state as per the following two way? First case, the contract provision state that the dates for possession and completion of each section are inserted into the contract as a series of dates. The date for completion of section 1 of may be 25th of March and the date for possession of section 3 of may be 30th of March. In that way, where the dates for possession and completion are simply expressed as a series of dates, there is nothing to put the contractor on notice of the likely problem. The contractor is likely to argue that the employer is in breach of contract and he would be correct. Second case, the contract provision state that section 1 would have a date for possession and a date for completion, but section 3 would not have a date for possession. The contract stated the date for possession section 3 is 5 days after the date of practical completion of section 1. In that way, a delay to completion in section 1 would be reflected in the date of possession of section 3, and breach of contract, damages and extension of time to section 3 would not be relevant.